Okay, simple free access mailing in SprutCAM. Stage 1, import the part. Okay, the part contains the surfaces and curves. Okay, I don't need curves, so just delete it. And next stage, locate the origin. Right now part is located in this origin. I would like to transform the part. So to do it, select the part, click transform button, and click locate zero, and locate the origin in this position. Okay. After that, go to machining. Define the workpiece. Click this button to and we can see the workpiece. It is transparent. Visibility buttons is here, so we can see the workpiece. And I would like to add the additional stock on the top. So click primitive, set box, and say positive stock is 1 millimeter. Okay, right now I can see 1 millimeter of stock. Okay, the next stage. I would like to make the face milling. It's version 10. Version 9 doesn't have this operation. Create new operation, roughing face milling. We can see the tool. Click this page and, for example, edit the tool. Click calculate toolpath. The parameters of operation is here. For example, this one or this one. Okay, let's check the result. Go to simulation and run the simulation process. Okay, perfect. So the next stage, I would like to machine all these holes. To do it, create new roughing waterline operation. Create. We can see the tool. To set the correct tool, measure these faces. Double click on it, and I can see the tool diameter 6 is good for me, but I set tool diameter 5 millimeters, and length is, for example, 40 millimeters. This one. Okay, and that's all. Right now, just click run. Feed rates. Okay, it's because only one face was added in the job assignment. Deleted. So nothing in the job assignment. Calculate run. So calculation will take 4 seconds. And we can see that everything is machined. Okay, one small problem. To resolve the problem, change this simulation to solid. Okay. And recalculate the toolpath. Perfect. Go to simulation and watch the result. Change the simulation mode to voxel. Watching result, first operation and second operation. Perfect. But for example, if I don't want to machine outer pockets, how to do it? I don't want to machine, for example, these pockets by this tool. I can define the job zone. To write the job zone, go to 2D geometry, select profile building, and just select the zone I would like to machine. Very, very approximately. And close. After that, go to machining back and select this profile and in the job assignment, edit as the job zone. Recalculate the toolpath. So right now the machining is performed only in the inner pockets. Very good. The next stage. We can watch the simulation. Click this button. And okay, the helical motions is higher than we need. To make it exact, we need to define the top level in this second operation. Select this face and click top level. Okay, right now helical motions started on this plane. Okay, go to simulation, click this button. Perfect. We can define all the steps, layer dev, kind of plunge here on this page and on this page. And the help also is available. Okay. The next. I would like to machine these inclined faces, for example. How to? I will use Morph operation to do it. Create new finishing morph. Okay, the tool I would like to use is spherical mill, 5 millimeters diameter. Length is, for example, 30. And morph operation need to drive curves. I would like to, for example, select this face and say this is machining face, and after that enable in the filter selecting of the edges, select this edge and say it's the first curve, select this edge, it's the second curve, and try to calculate. Okay, we can see. And also, for example, I would like to machine from down to up. To make it, I need to set mill mode conventional, and long link types, set feed distance is perfect, and insert smooth link radius. Oops, something wrong. Maybe rapid distance. Okay, yes, it's good. And say rapid distance is 5 millimeters, and let's define this. Okay, it's perfect. Define the step, for example, 0.25 millimeters. Calculate. Okay, I machined one curve, but I would like to machine all these curves. So measure the size of the 22.5 and this 2. So the step 24.5. In finishing morph, go to transformation, multiply toolpath along x-axis, step 24.5, and multiply count is 11. Okay, so it is machined. The next, for example, I would like to machine these open pockets by quite big tool, and I will use contouring operation to do it. Create new finishing 2D contouring operation. Okay, this tool is good for me, and now I would like to define the edges I want to come along. This one, and hold Ctrl to add, and add into the job assignment of the. Okay, click arrow to change the direction, and I can also define the numbers of levers. So, for example, I would like to use 3 millimeters depth step. Okay, and do the same from the another side. Double click, select all edges that is connected smoothly, and with control select this one, go to job assignment, add the curve, click arrow to change the direction. It's possible to add the approaches and retraction, calculate. So that's perfect, and we can watch the result of machining now. Face milling is the first. Pockets. Another pockets. Inclined surfaces. Very good. And outer open pockets. Okay. I have unmachined areas here. If I would like to machine it, I can use, for example, the same roughing water line. Create new roughing water line. Copy all parameters from the second water line. This I need the tool diameter 5, and in the job zone, clear the job zone. Add these faces. I want to machine this one, this one, this one, and this one, and try to calculate. Okay, it calculates the workpiece. Okay, we can see it is machined. I can set, for example, clean milling. And depth step is set, for example, this one. Calculator. Okay, go to simulation and watch the results. Okay. Perfect. Thank you for your attention.